Hey everyone, Hakluke here. The title isn't clickbait. I actually did resign from Bugcrowd, and I know a lot of people are gonna be like, why did you do that? So I thought I'd make a video explaining exactly why. And also I'm gonna talk a bit about the projects that I've got lined up for post-Bugcrowd life. Before I start, I need to make one thing like super clear, and that is that there's no angst between myself and Bugcrowd. I really loved working for Bugcrowd, and I loved the people, I loved the projects I was working on, I was getting paid great money. Like, I would recommend it to anyone. It's really, really a good organization to work for. But I had some personal things that made me want to quit my job, basically. So it comes down to two things, pretty much. It comes down to wealth and freedom. So I'm gonna explain that further. Back in late 2019, I was buying my first home with my wife. And you know, we were looking at these houses and we weren't sure how much we could afford because like we'd never gotten a bank loan before, and we didn't really know what houses were worth and things like that. So we kind of did our research, and then we realized we can't afford the house of our dreams. And that was kind of disappointing, really. Like, I was a bit gutted about that because I felt like I'd been working for 10 years or more. I've been working for like a decade and I still can't buy what I want. Why is that? Like, what am I doing wrong? And it affected me probably more than it should have. And I got a little bit obsessed with reading all of these like how to get wealthy books. But I learned so much in that period. Because these books, a lot of these books are about more than just money. They're about, you know, life, and there are a lot of lessons you can learn from them. So I read like probably 20 or 30 of these books about money, including all of the classics like Rich Dad, Poor Dad, Think and Grow Rich, Secrets of the Millionaire Mind, and a bunch of other ones. And I found after reading so many of them that they all kind of blur into one, and they all kind of end up saying the same thing. If you want to be wealthy, you shouldn't trade time for money because it's a bad deal, right? Basically, time, you can never get back. Once you've spent time, you can't get it back. Money is a renewable resource, right? It comes and goes. So time is super, super, super valuable, more so than money. So when you're basically earning money, you want to try and do that without trading such a valuable resource for it, right? And there are a couple of ways you can do that. You can do that by building a system that makes you money. For example, you could build a business that makes you money. Or you could do that by investing your money. So in that case, your money earns you more money, and that's kind of scalable and it doesn't take up your time, right? So building a business takes up your time, but the goal in the end is either to sell that business or to kind of set it up in a way that it's making you money while you don't have to do very much. So yeah, that is the definition of wealth for me. It's being able to earn enough money to live and spend money on whatever you want, but without having to actually trade your time for it. So the plan then becomes, I want to invest my money and I want to own a business and I want to stop trading time for money. So that's the first reason I left. The second reason I left is freedom, right? And freedom can mean a lot of different things, but you know, to name a few, freedom of time, freedom of location, freedom of, you know, financial freedom, freedom of expression, freedom of choice. There's a whole bunch of different types of freedom, I guess. But there's this weird thing where if you're employed by someone, you are kind of expected to forego some of those freedoms. So there's this disconnect between freedom and employment. And this is something that I kind of thought about a lot. And I kind of want to write a blog post about it, and I actually might now. But basically, when you are employed by someone, you sacrifice your time freedom because you have to work during specific times. You sacrifice some freedom of expression because you can't say exactly what you want to say. For example, if you want to say something on social media that would negatively affect your company, the company that you work for, then obviously you'll be sacked for that probably, or at least frowned upon, definitely. Next, if your boss asks you to do something, like, you have to do it, right? That's what you're getting paid for. So that's a freedom of choice thing. And if an employer decides that they want to sack you, then they can, and then you don't get paid anymore. So you're very, very reliant on them to give you money. And if you want to earn more money, working harder doesn't guarantee that you're going to earn more money, right? It just kind of, you kind of have to ask them for a pay rise, and then you might get it and you might not. So yeah, those kind of freedoms are things that are very important to me. And I've kind of been thinking about it for a long time and thinking, you know what, maybe I should try and do something about that. Maybe I should try and become more free, because that's really valuable. So the alternative that I'm trying to build for myself basically is I want to be able to decide when I work. I want to be able to decide how hard I work and what I work on and where I work from and who I work with. And I want to be able to express myself freely, okay? So in order to do that, I basically need to work for myself, which is what I'm planning on doing in my post-Bugcrowd life. So what am I doing next? I'm starting my own cybersecurity consultancy. That's probably the biggest thing. So I've got a website up now. It's haksec.io, haksec.io. We're focusing mostly on virtual CISO services. So basically for businesses who don't want to hire a full-time CISO, but they still need cybersecurity advice, like general advice, will be perfect for that, right? And we're also doing a bit of penetration testing. But honestly, I really want to focus on this virtual CISO thing, because as a pen tester, in my time as a pen tester, I spent a lot of my pen tests sitting there going, wow, these guys really didn't need this pen test. What they actually needed was just general advice, because you end up sitting there testing this one specific part of the organization, which is maybe quite secure. But then when you start looking at the organization as a whole, you start realizing that, okay, there's all of these attack vectors, all of these weak points in the organization that will never get looked at because they're not aware of them. And they're taking their cybersecurity advice about what to get tested from a salesperson who probably is trying to sell them something, not necessarily in their best interest, right? So that's something that I'm really passionate about, like giving good general cybersecurity advice. And I think a lot of organizations need it. So I'm really excited about that. I'm going to be focusing on two other things though, other than that cybersecurity consultancy. The first one is bug bounties. I'm so excited to get back into bug bounties. Just this last kind of week or two, I've started hacking at night again, and it's been really, really fun. And I found some cool bugs, but I haven't really focused on that for the last kind of 12, 14 months because I've just been really busy with my job at Bugcrowd. And to be honest, like, I'm working in the bug bounty space already from 9 to 5, and then it gets to 5 o'clock and I'm like, I don't think I can do any more bug bounties. I'm just a bit over it. So yeah, I'm excited to be getting motivated for that again and actually doing some more hacking, because I didn't get to do much. And the last thing I'm going to be doing is content creation. So both for myself and for other organizations. The content I'm making for myself is going to be focused around cybersecurity in general, but one of the things I really want to focus on is transparency in my bug bounty hunting. So I want to talk about the kind of bugs that I'm looking for, the techniques I'm using, the types of bugs that I'm actually finding, and how much money I'm earning. Whenever I find a duplicate or a low quality bug or whatever, I'm going to tell you, about lessons I learned and everything. I'm just going to be super transparent about it. I'm really, really excited for that. Obviously, I can't say everything. Like, when I find a SQL injection in a program, I can't tell you what the program is, but I might tell you kind of techniques on how I found it and things like that. Last but not least, I just want to put this out there. I'm not recommending that other people quit their job in order to kind of go freelance, right? This has been a long time coming for me. I've done a lot of planning, and even now it is a huge risk for me, especially because I have a family to provide for. And the truth is, I don't know if it's going to work out. I hope that it does, absolutely. But I'm kind of comforted by the fact that if in 6 months' time it doesn't work out and I end up back in the workforce, I'm going to have a whole new appreciation for how awesome it is earning a salary and, like, you know, just having that security and that safety net of full-time employment. So I don't recommend that you follow in my footsteps unless you really, really have planned for it and everything. If you would like to support me in this journey, this risky, crazy journey that I'm going on, then you can do so in a number of ways. You can sponsor me on GitHub. If you know anyone who wants cybersecurity services, you can refer them to my website, haksec.io, haksec.io. And you can hire me to create content for your organization to do with cybersecurity. You can sponsor my content as well. But you know, the best way that you can help me out is just to share my content on Twitter and Instagram and TikTok and YouTube and anywhere else that I end up posting. Share it far and wide to anyone who you think will listen. That will really help support me. On that note, you're watching this video on YouTube, so like this video and subscribe to my channel. That would be so awesome. All right guys, I'm out. It's actually getting quite late here, but I will see you in the next video, and I can't wait. See you guys.